Freedom by Dilene Hinton. You think you're free? Is that what you call freedom? Freedom is having the ability to have a temporary home wherever and whenever I need to. I have no need for large permanent homes. Mine are exactly what I need, very environmentally friendly, and lasts for however long I need it. I can move on any time. It's knowing that I can wake up at a time that is appropriate for me and make as much noise as I need to and not care whether that wakes you up or annoys you. But I hope you like hearing me in the early mornings. It is knowing that I can build my home in any tree, and if that is on your property, there is nothing you can do about it. If I or my family feel threatened in any way, I can attack and I always win. I can glide through the air with all my friends and take over your lawns and eat as much of what I need. If I'm quick enough, I can grab that chip from your paper wrapping so fast and you have no chance of catching me. It's the freedom of being as close to the sky as I can and looking down on you. And if you think you can sneak a quiet kiss in a secret place in the outdoors, I'm watching. I see you from a branch on the tree that you're leaning against. And if you feed me, I can become your friend, but never your captive. I can perch on your fence and it's not trespassing. There are no laws that I'm accountable to. I have no bills to pay. I can crap any time I want to, and that can be sitting on a high wire above you or while I'm flying, and if it lands on your head, that's just your bad luck. You had better have those precious fruits in your gardens protected, because if you do not, I would have taken bits out of each of them as it suits me, which makes them not edible for you. I can stomp on your tin roof in the early hours of the morning, and did I hear you say you wake up to the chirping of birds? It's not as if you have a choice. You see, freedom is a pair of wings, and if you looked behind your back, you do not have them, which means you are not as free as me. I have the ultimate freedom, freedom to take off in flight any time I want to. I can fly solo or in my groups, and I'm not sure who has a longer life, you or me, but one thing I know, that my life, however short or long, will be what fits the meaning of the word freedom. So if you have any desire to lock me up in a cage, you better think again. All that food and care that you provide me, all of that training to talk and unnecessary chatter, is not going to change the fact that you have made me a prisoner. What were you thinking? How can you have put the words cage and wings together? If I have wings, I was meant to fly, and with flight comes the ultimate freedom. But how would you know? You don't know the freedom like I do, and for all of my friends that sit trapped in a cage in pet shops and homes, I say to them, everything that goes around comes around. So hang in there, mates, your freedom will come just as much as their karma will. We were given wings because we were meant to fly. I thought that was obvious. If you were born with wings on your back, you'd for no reason at all lock yourself up in a cage and allow yourself to be at the mercy of food and care by someone that thought they were doing the best for you. You think you're free, but your freedom is limited. It's you that has restrictions and rules. It's you that lock yourself in cages when the door is always open, not me. I'm free, and don't you ever forget that. I would not have been created with wings if I was not meant to have freedom. Freedom with restrictions is not truly freedom. But then you're mere humans. You were meant to have limited freedom because there's no telling what you would have done with your freedom if you did have wings. I am a bird. I have the wings, and to me, my freedom is limitless. So don't you dare.